So my name is Rob Siddall. I'm a lecturer in robotics and mechanical engineering sciences. I work in the Center for Aerodynamics and Environmental Flow. My research is all about understanding how animals move with such reliability. You know, animals can usually adapt to wind, rain, changes in their environment. So we sort of focus on what the tricks they have to do that, and then we try and use them in robots. Behind me, you have a mechanical catapult, which we're using to fling robotic geckos across the room. So I've been working with some biologists from UC Berkeley in California and the Max Planck Institute in Stuttgart, and they have spent months and years collecting data on geckos and how they glide through tropical rainforests. One of the problems you have with wild animals is you don't want to stress them out too much by making them do too much. They're hard to capture, it's hard to get the footage. And you can't make them do what you want. Some days they're hungry, some days they're tired. Where I come in is I build robots that are the exact same size, and they can steer and move in the air. With these, we can get a lot more data that are hard to get about the animals. We can tell them to do exactly what we want, and we can test our hypothesis that way. A gecko that's about this big can go through miles of rainforest, and it can swim, climb, crawl, fly. Whereas I think if you took maybe 100 meters of dense forest, there's almost no robot in the world that can get through that. So the idea is that if we can make robots go more places, we can make robots do more things and get more data. We've had to do a lot more modeling and fewer experiments, but I have to thank my students who spent a lot of time doing engineering in their bedroom. We've been mailing parts back and forth, but it's not really slowed us down too much, to be honest. Surrey is very environmentally focused. We've got several centers focused on our sustainability and helping sort of the modern world function. So working with animals makes you acutely aware of the sort of ongoing biodiversity loss. So going forward, I'm going to be trying to use robots in ways that can help the environment. So I try and make robot ecologists.